Welcome back to my class in statistics. Today we will continue with our discussion with group data. And today I will teach you how to compute the median of group data as well as the fractals for group data. And we start with the median as we have defined before. The median is the middle score that divides the set of data into equal parts, the upper 50% and the lower 50%. For ungrouped data, it's easier to find the median by first arranging the set of values in ascending or descending order and locating the score that you find at the middle or center. And if you find two middle values, the median is equal to the mean of these two middle values. If there is exactly one middle value at the center, then that value is the median. For group data, we use the following formula to find the median. The median is denoted by X sub m, m for median, and the median for group data is equal to L sub m plus quantity n divided by 2 minus Cf sub m minus 1 multiply by W divided by F sub M. L sub M here is the lower class boundary of the median class. Again, L sub M is the lower class boundary of the median class. And in the previous lesson, we have shown that the lower class boundary is obtained by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit of class interval. Like for example, for the interval 32 to 36, the lower limit is 32. If you subtract 0.5 from 32 minus 0.5, you get 31.5. Then 31.5 is the lower class boundary of the interval 32.36. L sub m is the lower class boundary of the median class. And the median class is the class interval that contains the median. N divided by 2. And here is the sample size, which is equal to the sum of the frequencies. Hence, the summation of the frequencies is the sample size denoted by small n. Or n is equal to the last cumulative frequency. And the cumulative frequencies are known to be the running sum of the frequencies. And the last cumulative frequency should always be equal to the sample size. And the divisor of n here is 2 because the median divides the set of data into two equal parts. As I said earlier, the upper 50% and the lower 50%. And these two equal parts explain why we have 2 in the denominator of n over 2. Cf sub m minus 1, Cf is the cumulative frequency. M sub 1 means the interval below the median class, but it is not literally the interval below. It means the interval before the median class. In the denominator, F sub m, this is the frequency of the median class. And W is the class tweed. And if you are given the class intervals, to find the class tweed, you simply count the number of values in any class interval. From 27 to 31, we have 5 values, beginning from 27, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. So you have 5 values from 27 to 31. Therefore, the class tweed is 5. And the same for any other interval in this given set of, in this group data. For the interval 62 to 66, the class tweed is also 5 denoted by W because you have 5 numbers from 62 to 66. 62, 63, 64, 65, 66. Hence, the class tweed is 5. the sample size is 90. To find the median, the first step is to find the median class. And to find the median class, you calculate n divided by 2. Where n is the sample size, 90 divided by 2 is 45. Now, we will find the interval that contains the 45th value. The values are arranged from the lowest to the highest. And to find the interval that contains the 45th value, that is the median class. The class interval that contains the 45th value is the median class. And to find the 45th value, we will use the cumulative frequencies. For example, the cumulative frequency of 7 means that there are 7 values from 27 to 36. And 2 of the 7 values are between 27 to 31, which means that the other 5 values are between 32 to 36. Again, from 27 to 36, there are 7 values. The cumulative frequency of 7 means that there are 7 values or 7 numbers from 27 to 36. And 2 of these 7 values are between 27 to 31, which means that the third value, the 4th, the 5th, the 6th, and the 7th value are in the interval 32 to 36. The cumulative frequency of 55 means that there are 55 values or 55 numbers from 27 to 51. And 2 of these 55 values are between 27 to 31. 7 of the 55 values are between 32 to 36. 16 of the 55 values are between the numbers 42 to 46. 34 of the 55 values are between 42 to 46. Again, 34 of the 55 values are between 42 to 46. The cumulative frequency of 55 means that there are 55 numbers between 27 to 51, and 34 of these values are between 42 to 46, which means that the 35th value, the 36th, 37th, up to the 55th value, and that's 21 values, are between 47 to 51. Now we want the class interval that contains the 45th value. And by inspection of these cumulative frequencies, we do not find the 45th value in the interval 42 to 46 because the cumulative frequency of 42 to 46 is 34, which means that there are only 34 values from 27 to 46. Therefore, the 45th value is not found in this interval 42 to 46, which means that the 45th value is found in the interval 47 to 51 because this cumulative frequency of 55 means that we have 55 numbers from 27 to 51 and 34 of them are between 42 to 46. And 21 of them, if you add 34 and 21, you get 55, which means that 21 of the values are between 47 to 51. Those are the values from the 35th, 36th, 37th, 38th, 39th, up to the 55th value. Therefore, the 45th value or number is found in the interval 47 to 51. And this is what we call the median class, denoted by MC. Median class now is 47 to 51. And the lower limit of the median class is 47. Therefore, the lower class boundary of the median class, denoted by L sub n, is 46.5, obtained by subtracting 0.5 from 47. Or 47 minus 0.5 is 46.5. And the frequency of the median class 47 to 51 is 21. thus f sub m is equal to 21. And the cumulative frequency of the interval below the median class is 34. Our median class is 47 to 51. As I said earlier, the interval below the median class is not literally the interval under or below the median class. It is the interval below the median class is the lower class boundary. The lower class interval or the class interval preceding that comes before the median class. The median class is 47 to 51. And the class interval that comes before it is 42 to 46. This is the lower class interval or the class interval below the median class, not this interval 52 to 56. The interval below the median class is 42 to 46 and its cumulative frequency is 34. Therefore, C f sub m minus 1 is 34. Now we substitute these values. L sub m 46.5, f sub m equals 21, cf sub m minus 1 equals 34, and w, as I said earlier, is equal to 5. The class 3 w is 5 into the formula for calculating the median for this group data. Thus, x sub m is equal to lower class boundary of the median class 46.5 plus n divided by 2 is 45 minus cumulative frequency of the interval below the median class is 34. This is the median class 47 to 51, and the class interval below it is 42 to 46, and its cumulative frequency is 34. Divide by the frequency of the median class, which is 21, multiplied by the class 3. And using your calculator, you should get 49.12. You start with the operation inside the quantity, 45 minus 34, you press equals in your calculator. Then divide by 21, press equal sign, and multiply by 5, press equal sign, plus 46.5. And you should get 49.12, that is the median class. That means 49.12 is the number exactly at the center of the distribution of these 90 values or 90 scores. If you will arrange the numbers from the lowest to the highest, you will find this number exactly at the center of those arranged set of values. And the interpretation of this median, 49.12, is that 50% of the scores, or 50% of the 90 values, or 45 values, are above 49.12. And another 50% of the values, or another 45 values, are below the median of 49.12. Again, the interpretation of the median 49.12 is as follows. You say 50% of the scores or 45 values are above the median 49.12. And another 50% of the values or another 45 numbers or values are below the median of 49.12. Next, I will teach you how to compute the fractals. For group data, as we said earlier, there are three sets of fractals, the quartiles, the deciles, and the percentiles. And we start with quartiles that divide the set of data into four equal parts. And as we said before, if you divide the set of data into four equal parts, you only need 3 points to divide a set of data into four equal parts, and each part would be 1/4 of the whole set of data or 25% of the data. And these 3 points correspond to the three quartiles. The first of the three sets of fractals or quantiles is the set of quartiles. The quartiles divide the set of data or distribution of data into 4 equal parts. And so each part is 1/4 of one whole or 25% of the set of data. And there are 3 quartiles because we need 3 points to divide a distribution of data into 4 equal parts. To calculate the quartiles for group data, we use the following formula. Q sub k denotes the kth quartile, and Q sub k is equal to L sub k plus quantity nk divided by 4 minus cf sub k minus 1 all over f sub k multiplied by w. L sub k is the lower class boundary of the kth quartile class, and the lower class boundary is obtained by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit of the class interval. The denominator of nk is 4 because quartiles divide a set of distribution into 4 equal parts. Earlier, when we computed for the median, we see that the denominator of n is 2 because the median divides the set of data into 2 equal parts. Now, the denominator is 4 because the quartiles divide the set of data into 4 equal parts. And cf sub k minus 1 is the cumulative frequency of the interval below the quartile class. Or cf sub k minus 1 is the cumulative frequency of the interval preceding that comes before the k quartile class. F sub k is the frequency of the k quartile class, and W is the class 3. We use the same set of group data for our example. We will compute the third quartile class. The value of k goes from 1 to 3 because we need 3 points to divide a set into 4 equal parts. So there are 3 quartiles. So the values of k are 1, 2, or 3. For the third quartile class, this implies k is equal to 3. And we start, as with the median, to find the k quartile class. In this example, the third quartile class. The third quartile class is the class interval that contains the value of q sub 3, or the third quartile. To find the third quartile class, we compute nk divided by 4, where n is the sample size, which is equal to the summation of the frequencies or the last cumulative frequency. Multiply by k because you want the third quartile class, k is 3, and divide by 4, 90, multiply by 3, divide by 4 is 67.5. As we said earlier, in finding the median class or the quartile class, the basis is the cumulative frequency. And as you can see, the cumulative frequencies are integers or whole numbers. Hence, if you get a value of a decimal number, round it off to whole number. And we find the third quartile class using C68. But in computing the value of the third quartile class, we substitute the original value of nk divided by 4, which is 67.5, and not the rounded off value. We only use the rounded off value for finding the quartile class. In this example, the third quartile class, because as I said, the basis for finding the third quartile class is the cumulative frequencies that are positive whole numbers. So we are looking for the interval that contains the 68 value or 68 number. And by inspection of the cumulative frequencies, the 68 value is within the interval, class interval 52 to 56. It is not found in the interval 47 to 51, the value of the third quartile, because we only have 55 values from 27 to 51. Hence, the 68 value is found in the class interval 52 to 56. Hence, our third quartile class is 52 to 56. and the lower class boundary of this class interval is obtained by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit 52. 52 minus 0.5 is 51.5. That is the lower class boundary of the third quartile class 52 to 56. We find the cumulative frequency of the interval preceding the third quartile class, or the cumulative frequency before the third quartile class. The third quartile class is 52 to 56. The class interval before that is 47 to 51, whose cumulative frequency is 55. Hence, Cf sub k minus 1 is 55. And the frequency of this interval 52 to 56, or the third quartile class, is 18. Hence, f sub k is 18, and the class width is 5, which you can get by counting the number of values from the lower limit to the upper limit of the class interval. Like 57 to 61, you have 5 numbers. You count from 57 to 61. 57, 58, 59, 60, 61. Hence, the class width is 5. And we substitute all these values, L sub k, Cf sub k minus 1, F sub k, and W into the formula for computing the quartile. In our example, the third quartile is equal to 51.5, L sub k is 51.5, plus quantity N sub k over 4. We substitute the original decimal number or unrounded answer, 67.5, minus the cumulative frequency of the interval before the third quartile class, 55, divided by the frequency of the third quartile class, or the frequency of the interval 52 to 56, which is 18, and multiplied by W, class width, 5. Using your calculator, you compute the difference, 67.5 minus 55, press equal sign, multiply by 18, press equal sign, divide by 18, press equal sign, and multiply by 5, press equal sign, plus 51.5, and you should get 54.97. This is rounded up to 2 decimal places. Again, 67.5 minus 55 equals, divide by 18 equals, multiply by 5 equals, plus 51.5 equals 57.97. This is the value of the third quartile, denoted by Q sub 3. For the interpretation, this means that 75%, or 3/4, k is 3. 3 divided by 4, 3/4, that's 75% of the values, or approximately 68 values. That's 3/4 of 90. 68 values are below the third quartile, 54.97. Again, 3/4 or 75% of the values, or approximately 68 values, are below 54.97. And 25%, that's 100, minus 75% is 25%. 25% of the values, which is 12, subtract 9, subtract 68 from 90, that's 12. Or approximately 12 values are above 54.97. Again, 3/4 of the values, or 75 of the values, or approximately 68 values, are above 54.97. And 25% of the values, 25% of 90, that's approximately 12, 90 minus 68. 22. 22 values are above the third quartile, 54.97. Again, 75% of the values, or approximately 68 values, are below the third quartile, 54.97. And 25% of the values, or 90 minus 68, that's 22 values, are above, greater than, the third quartile, 54.97. The second set of fractiles or quantiles is the set of deciles. The deciles divide the set or distribution of data into 10 equal parts. And we need 9 points in order to divide a set of data into 10 equal parts. This is the formula to calculate the decile of group data, denoted by D sub k, that's the kth decile. D sub k is equal to S sub k plus quantity nk divided by 10. The denominator now of, or divisor of nk is 10 because the deciles divide the set of data into 10 equal parts. Minus Cf sub k minus 1 all over F sub k multiplied by W, where W again is the class tweed. F sub k is the frequency of the kth decile class. Cf sub k minus 1 is the cumulative frequency of the interval below the kth decile class, but this is actually the cumulative frequency of the interval that comes before the kth decile class, or the cumulative frequency of the interval preceding that comes before the kth decile class. And the values of k are from 1 to 9 because we need 9 points to divide a set of data into 10 equal parts. For our example, we find the 7th decile, the value of the 7th decile. And this implies that k is equal to 7 if you want the 7th decile. To find the class interval that contains the value of D7 or the 7th quartile, we compute N sub k divided by 10. And the interval that contains the value of the 7th quartile is called the 7th decile class. Again, the first step is to find the class interval that contains the value of the 7th decile. And this class interval that contains the value of the 7th decile is called the 7th decile class. And we compute N sub k divide N k divide by 10, where N is the sample size equal to the summation of frequencies, or the last cumulative frequency, 90. For the 7th decile class, k is 7, and we divide by 10. And we get 63. Now, using cumulative frequency, we find the interval that contains the 63rd value. By inspection of the cumulative frequencies, the 63rd value is contained in the interval 52 to 56. Thus, this class interval 52 to 56 is the 7th decile class. The 7th decile class is the class interval 52 to 56. The value of D7 should be between 52 to 56. Or using class boundaries, the value of D7 should be between 51.5 to 56.5. And if this is the 7th decile class, the lower class boundary of this class interval is obtained by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit 52. 52 minus 0.5 is 51.5. And the cumulative frequency of the interval that comes before the 7th decile class 52 to 56, the class interval that comes before 52 to 56 is 47 to 51, and its cumulative frequency is 55. Hence, the value of Cf sub k minus 1, or the cumulative frequency of the interval below the 7th decile class, is 55. And F sub k is the frequency of this class interval 52 to 56, or the 7th decile class, its frequency is 18. Hence, F sub k is 18, and the value of the class tweed W is 5. and we substitute these values into the formula for computing the decile. For the 7th decile, D7 is equal to 51.5, the lower class boundary of the 7th decile class, 51.5, plus quantity NK divided by 10, 63, minus cumulative frequency of the interval below the 7th decile class is 55, divided by the frequency of the interval 52 to 56, 18, and multiply by 5. Again, use your calculator to compute this value. You can type this directly into your calculator, or you may start with 63 minus 55, press the equal sign, divide by 18, press the equal sign, multiply by 5, press the equal sign, plus 51.5. Rounded up to 2 decimal places, you should get 53.72. If the deciles divide the set of data into 10 equal parts, then each part is 1 over 10 of 1 whole, or 1 over 10 of the entire set of data, or that's 10%. Each part is 10% of 1 whole. For the interpretation of the 7th decile class, this means 7 parts. Hence, 70% of the values, 70% is 7 over 10, 70% of 90 is 63, 70% of the values, or approximately 63 values, are below the 7th decile, 53.72. And 30%, that's 100 minus 70, 30%, or approximately 90 minus 63 is 27. And 30% of the values are approximately 27 values, 90 minus 63, 27 values are above the value of the 7th decile, 53.72. Again, for the interpretation of the 7th decile, 53.72 means that 70% of the values, or approximately 63 values, are below 53.72. And 30% of the values, or approximately 27 values, 27 is 90 minus 63, are above, greater than, the 7th decile, 53.72. The last set of fractals or quantiles is the set of percentiles. The percentiles divide the set of data into 100 equal parts. There are 99 percentiles because we need 99 points in order to divide a set of data into 100 equal parts, and each part is 1% or 1 over 100 of the entire set of data. For group data, the formula to calculate the kth percentile is given by the following. Denoted by P sub K, this is the kth percentile, is equal to L sub K plus NK divided by 100. Notice that the denominator of NK now is 100 because, as we said earlier, the percentiles divide the set of data into 100 equal parts, minus the cumulative frequency of the interval before the kth percentile class, divided by F sub K, the frequency of the kth percentile class, multiplied by W or class 3. And the values of K go from 1 to 99, because we need 99 points to divide a set of data into 100 equal parts. For our example, we will find the value of the 39th percentile, denoted by P sub 39. If you want P sub 39, this implies that the value of K, the subscript K, is 39. And to find the class interval that contains the value of P sub 39, or the 39th percentile, we compute nk divided by 100, where n is the sample size equal to 90, 90 is equal to the sum of the frequencies or the class cumulative frequency multiplied by k for the 39th percentile, k is 39, and divide by 100, you should get 35.5. Again, for the purpose of finding the 39th percentile class or the class interval that contains the 35th score, we round off the decimal number 35.1 to whole number. Because, as I said earlier, the basis for finding the percentile class or the quarta class or the decile class is the cumulative frequency. And the cumulative frequencies are all whole numbers. Now, we find the class interval that contains the 35th score or value. By inspection of these class frequencies, we do not find the 35th value in the interval 42 to 46 because the cumulative frequency of 42 to 46 is 34. And this means that there are only 34 values from 27 to 46. Hence, the 35th score or value is not contained in the interval 42 to 46, but it is contained in the next interval, 47 to 51. The 35th value is between 47 to 51, and this is our 39th percentile class, 47 to 51. And its lower class boundary, 46.5, is obtained by subtracting 0.5 from the lower limit of this 39th percentile class, 47 minus 0.5, 46.5. Cf sub k minus 1 is the cumulative frequency of the interval that comes before 47 to 51. Our 39th percentile class is 47 to 51. The interval before that is 42 to 46, and its cumulative frequency is 34. Thus, Cf sub k minus 1 is equal to 34. And F sub k is the frequency of this 39th percentile class, 47 to 51, and its frequency is 21. Thus, F sub k is 21, and as before, W or class width is 5. Again, we substitute all these values into the formula for computing the k percentile class in our example. The 39th percentile is equal to the L sub k, the lower class boundary of the 39th percentile class, 46.5, plus quantity nk divided by 100. Again, we substitute the original value of n sub k, of nk divided by 100, the original decimal number, which is 35.5, minus the cumulative frequency of the interval below the 39th percentile class, which is 34, divided by the frequency of this 39th percentile class, 21, divided by 21, multiplied by W, which is 5. Again, using your calculator, you can compute this directly in your calculator, or you start with 35.1 minus 34 equals, divide by 21 equals, multiply by 5 equals, plus 46.5. And you should get 46.76. That's rounded off to 2 decimal places. Always round off your answer to 2 decimal places. For our interpretation, this is the 39th percentile class. Hence, 39% of the values, that's approximately 39% of 90, is approximately 35 values are below or less than 46.76. And 100 minus 39, that's 61. And 61% or approximately 90 minus 35, that's 55. 90 minus 35 is 55 values are above 46.76. Again, for the interpretation of the 39th percentile equal to 46.76, 39% of the scores or values, or approximately 35 values, are below 46.76, and 61%, 100 minus 39, 61% of the values, or approximately 90 minus 35, or 55 values, are above or greater than 46.76, the 39th percentile. For your practice, please try the following exercises. And for these exercises, please use the same group data that we have used for our examples. Find and interpret number 1, Q1, first quartile, number 2, D3, third decile, number 3, D8, D sub 8 or 8th decile, number 4, P sub 29 or 29th percentile, 5, P sub 63 or 63rd percentile, and 6, P sub 81 or the 81st percentile. And for you to check your answers, these are the answers for number 1, 43.31, 2, 44.56, 3, 56.22, 4, 44.31, 5, 51.97, 6, 56.47. Another way to check if your answer is correct, once you have computed, for instance, the value of the first quartile, Q1, you can check your answer by checking if the value of Q sub 1 is within the first quartile class. Similarly, if you have computed the value of D sub 3, the value of D sub 3 should be within the interval of the third, for the third decile class. If you have computed P sub 81, so you will know the 81st percentile class, the value of the 81st percentile or the value of P sub 81 should be between or should be within the class interval for the 81st percentile class. And that completes our lesson for today for median and fractals for group data. In the next lesson, we will talk about kurtosis and skewness of distribution of data. Thank you for joining me in my class today in statistics.